is enough to have 14 separate islands. And most of these islands are connected by bridges or pathways. Now over here on the right, you will see that this is the first island on our tour. And this island is known as Hamlin's Point. Now Hamlin's Point was named after the Hamlin family, and they were some of the first year-round inhabitants here on these islands. Now the Hamlins were such kind people that they decided to open
high-rise building to Guelph City back during the mid-1990s. Now that's a comparison to now, when Toronto actually has the highest concentration of high-rise buildings under construction in the entire world. So we actually beat Dubai just about 2 years ago, with a total of over 300 high-rise buildings being built across our city as we speak. Funnily enough, we also have the highest concentration of cranes in any one city. So if you ever have some place you need to reach really high up, you can count on finding a crane in Toronto. We are now coming up to our stop number 15 here by Union Station. For anyone that's going to be hopping off at our stop number 15, you guys, like, looks like we have some people waiting for us. While we're pulling up to our stop, I really want to point out my favorite building in this city. So just up ahead, in front of the bus, you can spot this really big beige stone building that sort of dominates the plaza. Now you might notice, peeking out to the right of it, there's this tall golden tower that's very, very gold. Now, half of you aren't going to believe this, the other half are going to Google it right after. But that tower now looks so gold because it is actually made out of gold. Every single pane of glass in that building has 24 karats of gold pressed into it. So this is an art. Up to your right,
additions, a condo. We also have some interesting institutions here in the heart of Toronto. Here to our right is the home of the Toronto Star. The Toronto Star is Canada's most widely publicated newspaper. That building here right there, it was actually voted the ugliest building in Toronto by a poll that was put out by the Toronto Star themselves. Backfired on them a little bit. Toronto Star's had some pretty cool employees. Ernest Hemingway actually wrote for the Star. First appeared in Toronto later on as a foreign correspondent. We have here the Scenic Gardiner Expressway, the fastest way to drive in and out of the city here in downtown. Six bars above our heads. That next tunnel we're going to be passing underneath will be sitting much lower, so just a reminder for everyone up top to please remain seated. Clear up top, but I would like to recommend that everyone get their cameras ready as you pass the